Well,
not many people have reached out and shaken my hand.
Well, that's so.
And not many people do it the second time.
We're jumping here.
Sure. Jake, have a seat.
Here, Alfred, you don't mind if I sit this down, do you?
Yeah.
He's in the bag.
Yes,
right now.
I can see that. Wow.
That shouldn't be anything new. Alfred, it's just an old bag.
I know what's in that bag.
Oh, I see.
I've seen it open, believe
Jake,
me.
Jake Roberts, you are perhaps one of the most surprising things, I think, to ever arrive at the World Wrestling Federation. I just don't really know where you're coming from. You look a little worse for wear, by the way.
Well, I give a little, but I take a lot.
It's quite obvious. Mm-hmm. Where are you coming from, Jake? Am I throwing a curve at you here, pal?
Well, you're not throwing any curves at me. I know exactly where I'm coming from, you know. Doing what I do. I've got to go out there and create and be the man that I want to be. I have the opportunity to do that. Not many people have enough guts to do that, but I do.
Jake, I want to refresh your memory. Let's go back. Recently on Championship Wrestling, you were meeting Ricky Hunter and a whole lot of things happened. Vince McMahon, by the way, is at ringside to call the action. Let's join it in progress.
Joining us.
Jake Roberts, I don't mind telling you, in my estimation, my opinion, humble as it may be, You're a rather sick individual, with that snake especially.
Thank you.
You actually do take that as a compliment.
I live the way I want to. I don't live by your rules. I don't live by their rules. I live by my own rules because they fit me the best. Now, as far as Ricky Steamboat goes, let's get this straight right off the bat. Saturday night's main event. The reason that happened was because, very simply, if a man is thirsty, he finds water. If a man is hungry, he finds something to eat. And I'm a very hungry man. Steamboat just happened to be my piece of meat. And the flesh that I take, I shall not give back.
Wait a minute. Tell me more about the DDT.
Well, very simply, it's the very best hold in professional wrestling today, bar none. Nobody has ever gotten up from it, and they will not.
Lord Alfred Hayes, you've been in professional wrestling so many, many years. What do you make of the DDT? Is it not the most devastating move you've ever seen?
Of the present time, it is without a doubt the most crippling hold there is. And as of this moment in 1986, he has the what could you say, the infamous record of having put more men into hospital than any other single wrestler.
Well, I happened to be in Providence, Rhode Island during Saturday night's main event. I went back in the locker room, and there had to be a lump this large on the forehead of Ricky Steamboat. This man was out cold. Cold as a light.
Some people say he was starting to look like the Elephant Man, but that's his problem.
Wait a minute, you've not heard the last of Ricky Steamboat.
I'm not worried about hearing the last of Ricky Steamboat. Ricky Steamboat just stepped in an unfortunate situation because he was in the ring with me.
All right, Jake Roberts, the Snake.
Welcome.
I'm exactly looking forward, Jake the Snake Roberts, to this little tour. What is this?
It's a diamondback rattlesnake. You've probably seen a lot of them in the movies. They like to make noises. Come on, boy. Make some sounds.
Poisonous?
Very poisonous. Very poisonous.
Let me ask you a question. If somebody were to be bit by this diamondback rattler, mm-hmm. how long would it be before you bought the farm?
Well, it depends on the...
Hey, don't agitate him.
Oh, let's get him upset here. See if he'll make a little noise for us. Maybe we could actually get him out of the cage here and...
No, wait a minute. Not out of the cage.
It depends on the individual as far as how long you'd live.
Wait a minute. You've got him rattling now.
Oh, let's keep going.
That's a little sick as far as the display is concerned with a skull right in the cage.
Well, I'm sure that his ancestors have put several people into this position. A diamondback rattlesnake is a very quick, very quick.
What, do you keep these things around the house? Is that your thing?
That's the general idea. He almost
Wait a minute.
Got it.
Let's move along. What about this
here
one right
here? Here we go. Listen to this. Come on, boy. Come on.
It's hot.
Very hot. Yeah. That's a slight warning system. Most people don't understand that. That's a warning system for you. If you hear this noise, to back up. And you know what's funny? Most people do. Most people.
Moving right along, what do we have here?
Well, this is a Mexican rattlesnake. Differences in color, obviously quite a bit larger.
I understand that this snake actually bit somebody at one time and he didn't make it.
Well, you know, sometimes you just don't get people to the hospital in time, you know, and that's one thing you got to realize. If you're going to play with snakes, sooner or later you're going to get bit. Here, I want to show you something, though, huh? I want to show you a ring.
Well, wait a minute now.
Let's put him down here.
What do we have?
This one makes an unbelievable sound here. Watch this. Come on, boy. This is a viper.
Get away from me.
It's a very pretty snake, though. These are vipers.
Sure, they're pretty.
These are from Pakistan. Now, what's interesting about these fellas here is that the mortality rate, in other words, if you get bit, 95% of the time you won't live. You can't get anything to help you.
My God, what a thought, Roberts.
What a great system, though, huh? That way you're not a loser, for sure.
What?
Now, here's the prize, right here.
Oh.
What's
yeah.
him?
Oh.
You ever heard of a black mamba?
Can you move this away? It just makes me nervous as a lady of ill repute in the front pew of church. Go ahead.
This is a black mamba down here. They call them three-step mambas.
Three steps?
Because that's just about how long you're going to live, my man. Three steps. Now, right here, I think everybody can identify with these. These are cobras.
Oh, my word.
Beautiful cobras at that.
Don't get him hot.
Come on.
Geez, you agitate those
things. Let's get him to stand up here and spread out and show you what they look like.
Well, you're poking them.
Sure, I'm poking him. I'll poke Steamboat, too.
Good.
But Steamboat got away once. He will not get away again, promise you there.
Are there two of them in there?
Yeah, two nice ones. And if you look at the end of the bench here, that's the little baby of the mother and father here. You see, life goes on for some, but not for everyone. Here, let's get them to spread. That's what's really pretty is when they spread out and they look so pretty. And they're very beautiful animals. Snakes are very clean. Cruel but fair, right?
That's all right.
The way I got to look at it. Now I want to show you something.
We've only got time for...
I want to show you something here because, you know, I can associate...
Go right ahead.
People. Now, this big fat one down here, the real big one, reminds me a lot of Hulk Hogan. And I say that because Hulk Hogan is obviously the biggest man around the WWF. After all, he is world champion. But you look and see how lazy he's gotten. You're very lazy, Hogan. And I talk to this snake every night because sooner or later, Hogan will fall into the trap. Now, here's a little one down here that reminds me of Steamboat. Look at this fool. See how stupid he is? He's got himself upside down. That reminds me of Steamboat because Steamboat is knocking on the wrong door.
Oh, what about back in the bag?
Well, that's Son of Sam. That's what I named him. And that one reminds me a lot of me.
I'm going to go out on a limb. If we can just very quickly sneak back up here. Jake, I'm going to ask you. Your Lordship, come on up.
Are you sure?
Yes. He's assured me that we will be safe.
I changed my mind.
Oh, he's changed his mind.
Well, some people change their minds, and Steamboat should ask for some solid advice. And the best advice I got for you, Steamboat, is that if you're going to play with snakes, sooner or later you're going to get bit. Everybody knows that.
Yeah.
And this is a very beautiful snake here. But he's very rowdy. He reminds me of thee, of me, because... I'm very rowdy at times, too.
All right. Fans, stay tuned. We've got Danny Spivey and Mike Rotundo coming up after this as TNT continues. Stay tuned. Get rid of that thing.